NY Post has come out with their Metropolitan Division rankings, and today we're going to be taking a look at that, kind of taking a look at their 8-1 rankings, as well as especially where the Rangers sit in those rankings as well. And this is done by Ethan Sears of, like I said, NY Post. So starting off here at number 8, we have, should be no surprise to anyone, the Philadelphia Flyers. They're the worst team in this division, I think, for sure. I think they're going to be a fairly big step, not huge step back, but a decent-sized step back from the number 7 place team, which is, spoiler alert, the Blue Jackets. For the Flyers, though, they're not a good team. They're going to be a bad team. They've gotten even worse from last year. They're going to get worse. They're going to be a rebuilding team for a long time, and I do see them taking probably a big step back from last year as well. Could finish with even less wins than the Blue Jackets did last year, who had 25. They're going to be the 8th place team, I think, for sure, and they're going to be in a big rebuild here. Daniel Breyer is going to try and do his best to, you know, do as fast of a rebuild as possible, I'm sure, but they're going to be in rebuild for a while. They're going to get Michkov, which is obviously a great prospect, but he's not going to come for a while. They're going to be bad for a long time, and hopefully they stay bad for a while. But taking a look at number 7, though, we have the Blue Jackets. Like I said, last year they were number 8. The Flyers were also number 7 last year as well, but the Blue Jackets, they're kind of switching with the Flyers this year. I think they'll be a bit better, but I don't see them making the playoffs. I don't see them really sniffing the playoffs. They got Fantilli in this draft, obviously an elite prospect, but I don't see him carrying them to the playoffs. I don't think he'll probably have a 60-point season, 50-point season, something around there, I'm sure, especially if he's playing with guys like Laine and Gaudreau, but I do think that they're not going to be great this year, probably the 7th place team in this division. At number 6, we have the Pittsburgh Penguins, who finished 5th place last year, and Kyle Dubas has done an alright job. I don't think they have enough depth at defense or in the forward core to actually, you know, make a playoff push and really make a deep, long playoff run. Their goaltending is questionable at times with Jari, who's been injured quite a bit. They added in Riley Smith. They'll be a decent second liner, but I just don't think they have enough to really propel them into a playoff spot, especially with their depth issues. They don't have a lot of good young talent either, like coming up to the minors right now, or just even prospect pool is quite dry as well. So overall, their future looks horrible, and they're keep trading away picks as well. So the future is just looking worse and worse and worse with their aging core. It just doesn't seem like they're going to be able to make the playoffs in the next couple of years. I don't really see it happening. It's possible, but I just think they're going to get worse and worse, and I don't really know if they're going to make it to the playoffs, especially not next year. I mean, it's possible, but I just don't see it happening. Even though Crosby's amazing, him, Malkin, Letang, those guys are just getting older and older and older, and their core is just looking worse and worse and worse. Take a look at number 5 spot, though, kind of switching with the Penguins, who finished 5th place last year and are going to be 6th. We have the Capitals, who are in the 5th spot here and finished 6th last year, so they're kind of switching. Both are in the same kind of spot, though. Both have not great prospect pools and young talent, although the Capitals definitely do have some decent guys. I would say their prospect pool and young talent is definitely quite a bit better than the Penguins, but still not great. And their core is still getting older too. Ovi is getting older, although he is aging decently fine. He's still playing pretty well. It's just he's going to get older, he's going to get worse. Same with Backstrom, same with John Carlson. Those guys are getting older and worse, and their future is definitely not looking very bright for either team, but at least the Capitals do have some decent young talent coming up in the next couple of years. We'll probably see some of those guys playing this upcoming season as well. But taking a look at number 4 spot here, we have the Islanders, and not surprising at all, I think they can definitely be a playoff team this year. It's possible. They'll be a wildcard team if that, though. I think the top 3 is kind of set in the Metro again for this year, but I do think they'll be a solid team this year. Maybe speaking to a wild card spot, but definitely not a playoff spot. I don't see that happening. I think the top 3 is set. They're a decent team, have a not really a great future, and they've got some older kind of aging guys as well. So their future does not look very bright, and you know, long term wise. But I think for right now, they can definitely be a playoff team and definitely be a solid, you know, tough first round exit. But I don't see them doing much more than that. Being a first round exit is probably what their ceiling is next season. Take a look at number 3 spot, though, and he has the Rangers. So, unfortunately, for this list, the Rangers are here, but it's definitely possible. I can see the Rangers finishing 1st, 2nd, or 3rd. Same thing with all 3 of these teams. I think all 3 of these teams are kind of, you know, big steps ahead of the rest of the division. I think these kind of top 3 teams, Rangers, Canes, and Devils, are the top 3 teams, the clear top 3 teams in this division at this point. And yeah, it was a disappointing year last year, obviously losing in round 3. We finished 3rd place last year as well, so I do think that it's possible we could finish 3rd again and probably play it, you know, on the division team, whoever it is, whether it's Devils or the Canes. But I do think that, you know, with Laviolette coming in, hopefully things can look better, because we did just fairly recently make the conference finals, obviously losing to Tampa a couple years ago. But hopefully things can get better this year, and we can obviously have a much better, you know, season this year, and a much better playoff run. This should be very, very nice to see. If you look at the number 2 spot, they have the Carolina Hurricanes, a very solid team, very deep team, good experience, a lot of vets, a lot of young guys. Overall, they have a good mix of young and old talent. I think they're a great team defensively especially, but I do think they need to add some more scoring power up front, and they could definitely be a very lethal team. It's just their scoring is kind of lacking at times in critical moments. But overall, they finished in the conference finals last year. At the number one spot, though, the Devils. I think all three of these teams, Devils, Canes, and Rangers, are miles ahead of the fourth place team and worse. I don't see any of these teams dropping into the top three. I think we're kind of all three of us are set in the top three. It's just kind of who's going to finish first, second, and third. That's the big question mark. But I do think that all three of these teams are going to finish top three. All three are great teams. All three are deep teams as well, for the most part. And I do think that the Devils, they have a solid D-core. Nothing insane. I think for the future-wise, though, with Nemec and Luke Hughes coming up, they're going to have a very nice young D-core as well. But I think for right now, their D-core is not the best in the world. Could improve, but obviously with that young talent coming up, it's going to be really good soon. And their forward core is obviously fantastic. Timo Meier is a solid player. I think he's a little overrated by some people, but I think overall he's a pretty solid player. Jack Hughes is obviously a great player, really good offensively, absolutely fantastic talent. Although he isn't really good right on the faceoffs, he's still a great centerman, especially in the offensive zone. He's quite dynamic. Nearly 100-point guy, 99 points last year. I'm sure he'll get close to that again, if not breaking 100. And overall, though, they're a solid team. And overall, like I said, the top two teams are set pretty much. I definitely do think that the Rangers have a shot at number one spot in the division, though. Definitely don't count them out, because I think the Rangers are getting underrated a bit by a lot of people, kind of acting like the Canes and Devils are miles ahead. I don't think that's true at all. I think all three of these teams are very, very close, and definitely the Rangers could finish in that number one spot in the Metro Division this year. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have, please smash the like button and definitely comment down below your guys' thoughts on these rankings. Who do you have in your top three? Where do you have the Rangers finishing in the Metro Division? Thanks for watching, and see ya.